The place, the Isle of Crete. The year, about 1500 BC. Hey Sun Sway Sun, I'm Daisy Viktoria, and I am here today to share with you a love for a civilization long gone, which leaves behind traces of lost civilization, lost art, and a society that once was. What civilization am I talking about? That would be the Minoans. The term Minoans is actually not from the civilization, but from later, because of the legend of King Minos. In Greek mythology, King Minos builds a labyrinth to contain a minotaur. And this story is really cool, and I could totally go on a tangent, but we are here today to talk about Minoan costume. So that's where we're gonna focus. We can kind of piece together what the ancient Minoans wore based on a lot of the surviving artwork. We have a lot of paintings, frescoes, we even have jewelry inlaid with designs of, you know, Minoan people. We have statues. There's a lot to go off of, but we still have to interpret a lot. Now, I've been looking at Minoan clothing for a long time, but sort of in between my early attempts and my current attempts, there is an archaeologist, Bernice Jones, who actually has been studying and recreating Minoan clothing. And so when I went back to attempt Minoan clothing this time, I had read up on a lot of her work, and I took a lot of that into consideration. So I'll kind of show you in this video what I'm doing to bring the Minoan look to life. I have also put together a PDF tutorial to take you step by step through how to create your own Minoan wardrobe. So if you would like that, I will link it in the description for you below. The Minoans were a Bronze Age civilization which existed on the island of Crete in the Aegean Sea. Minoan civilization lasted from about 3500 BC to around 1100 BC. The more complex urban civilizations started to form around 2000 BC, and Minoan civilization started to decline around 1450 BC. In depictions of women from the Minoan period, we see a lot of sort of this basic tunic that's open in the front, and that is often worn with some sort of a wrap skirt. There are some other variations, such as the famous snake goddess statue, which I did attempt many years ago. But for the most part, we commonly see this tunic with an optional wrap skirt added, and often some sort of belt to hold it on. Depictions of Minoan men commonly show them wearing just that basic wrap skirt or kilt. This is a great look that I think my boyfriend would totally rock, but also I'm gonna go ahead and make him some tunics. For the tunics, I actually took my inspiration from Mycenaean artwork. Mycenaean civilization existed on mainland Greece as well as some of the Aegean islands. The Mycenaean period is approximately 1750 BC to 1050 BC. So as you can see, there is definitely some overlap with Minoans, and there was interaction between these two cultures, both of which are considered sort of precursors to the later Greek society. Okay, so what's better than one Minoan outfit? Two Minoan outfits? What's better than two Minoan outfits? Several interchangeable Minoan outfits? So I decided to create basically four pieces, so two tunics and two skirts that together would create six outfits. Pretty cool. So this is actually gonna show you how to create a whole Minoan wardrobe. And in addition to that, we are making male Minoan clothing for my boyfriend. I also made him two tunics and two kilts, along with sort of an extra layer kilt he can use for a two-layered one if he wants. I also made belts for these outfits, and there's jewelry, and it's very cool. So you're gonna get a whole wardrobe of both the masculine and the feminine Minoan people.
I started this project by taking a few measurements. Well, that's not entirely true. I actually started this project by reading a lot about Minoan archaeology and looking at a lot of Minoan artwork and analyzing and overanalyzing it. These clothes are not all that fitted, so pretty much I just needed my bust, a waistline where I want the skirt to sit, and a length of both my tunic and my skirt. Once I had my measurements, and also my boyfriend's for his outfits, I went to work calculating the pieces for this pattern. And the completely developed pattern diagram, after I finally made the garments and figured it all out, is what you can find in my PDF tutorial. While linen is the preferred fabric, I am actually using a cotton here, mostly because it was cheaper and I just kind of wanted to get something done that I thought would be nice to wear at very hot events. I am sticking primarily to colors that we see in the fresco images because I think that's really going to convey the whole Minoan look that I'm going for. The tunics I'm making are pretty much the same pattern for both female and male. They're essentially a sort of tea tunic. You can kind of think of it similar to a modern t-shirt, but if it stayed completely flat across the top with no shoulder shaping. I sewed the tunics together by stitching the shoulders and also the side seam all the way from the end of the sleeve to the hem. Working on my boyfriend's tunic, it was basically the exact same method for patterning and cutting out as mine was. The difference is that on the male tunic, I'm leaving it totally closed in the front, whereas the female tunic is cut open. And now it's time to work on our wraparound kilts. I started by cutting out a basic shape, which was flat on the bottom and then sort of angled at the waist. And then I tried that on to see how much I needed to cut off and shape at the bottom. Obviously, I needed to cut off quite a bit. And having tried it on, I had the perfect amount of how much I wanted to adjust for that. Here I'm working on a multi-layered kilt for myself, so I'm basically using that one layer to get an idea of the patterning for the other layers. Since the men also wear wrap kilts, I cut out a kilt for my boyfriend as well. And here we are trying them on to see what our outfits look like so far. This is always so exciting because at this point you start to get a sense of like what the whole outfit is going to look like, and it just really brings it to life and it's super exciting. Pleased with the overall fit, I moved on to the next step.
While the Minoan civilization may not be around anymore, studying their clothing and some of the things that made them who they were, I think is one amazing way to connect with those who walked the earth before us. And I think there's so much to learn and so much to connect with that is greater than ourselves. And I think that the further back I go in time, the more I feel this connection to those who were once there before me. And I think that's really powerful.
I'm using this trim that looks a lot like handmade trim, which is awesome because that's what I am going for. Minoan and Mycenaean tunics have trim basically going all the way down the sides where I have those side seams. So I decided to go ahead and put the trim over top of the side seam. Right now I'm pressing the side seams open and I'm actually pressing them toward the outside or the right side of the tunic. Since I'm going to cover them with trim, then pressing them toward the outside means that I don't need to finish off the seams on the inside because they're already sort of sandwiched underneath the trim. Now I do have some curvature in these side seams, so wherever it curves, I needed to clip it to get that nice curve. The process for this was exactly the same on my tunic, so I'm really focusing on one of them right here just to show you how it works. Belts can also be made of handmade trim. The fabric that I used for the wrap kilts kind of has that same look like woven trim, and I thought it would look nice for the belts. I made belts in a few colors. I used the same blue, red, and gold colored fabrics that I used for our kilts. And then I made tassels to match, and I put the tassels on the ends of each belt. A lot of the kilts in Minoan artwork have fringe at the bottom, so I decided to put fringe on the edges of our kilts. Now, what's a full wardrobe with only one tunic? I'm making another tunic for each of us out of this sort of off-white or unbleached muslin, and I'm basically just using our first tunics that I created as the pattern. I chose different trims for these tunics, once again going for trims that had that look of handwoven trim similar to what we see in the period artwork. Here you can see our finished tunics and the clever ways in which I overlapped all the ends of the trim so that I would have to hem as little as possible.
Are you guys excited? Because I am. I am really loving these Minoan looks, and I'm so excited to show you what they look like when I wear them.
And now I am going to show you the many ways you can wear these outfits. In total, for myself, I created two tunics and two kilts. I made some beaded necklaces just to kind of go along with what we see in the period pictures. Here is the burgundy red tunic. The The skirts are also interchangeable with both tunics. Here I'm wearing this light blue kilt skirt. This skirt is made in one layer. I just have two rows of fringy trim sewn onto it. And here is the three-layer kilt skirt. This one is the one I originally had intended to wear with this tunic. Here is my very light off-white tunic worn with a belt. A lot of tunics also have tassels hanging from the sleeves, which I think is such a cute detail, and I absolutely loved adding tassels to the sleeves. Here is my off-white tunic with that light blue skirt, which is the one I had originally intended to wear with that tunic. And here is my off-white tunic with the three-tiered skirt. Pardon my silly dancing. Apparently, this is the only clip I filmed for the reveal of this outfit, and I'm not really sure why, but I hope it's entertaining. All right, now let's move on to my boyfriend's Minoan wardrobe. Here is the first tunic I made for him, that dark blue tunic. Here is the blue kilt that I created for him. This also has fringe around the hem and a variety of trims. I also made him a yellow kilt. This was actually the first kilt I made for him. And I really like this color combo. I ended up creating an extra short blue kilt, so he can wear that on top of the yellow kilt for a two-layered effect. This is the second tunic I created for my boyfriend out of the same off-white muslin as my second tunic. That can be worn with the blue kilt. Here it is with the yellow kilt. And here it is with the two-layered kilt. Silly poses not required, but definitely extra fun. I have to tell you, I am absolutely in love with these Minoan wardrobes, and I cannot wait to wear them to some SCA events, possibly even the Renaissance Festival on warm weekends. The one near me has a Greek area, and I feel like Minoan costumes, though certainly not Renaissance, would fit in pretty well with the Greek theme.
If you find some inspiration from this video, if you make something using my PDF tutorial on Minoan clothing, or even any of my other ones, I would love to see what you make. So please tag me. I am Daisy Viktoria everywhere. My website is daisyviktoria.com. And a special thank you to my patrons over on Patreon who helped me so much to continue creating amazing content like this. I hope you all have a super magical day, and I'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.